there are two totally different debates, really. One is the Western debate, which is all about, well, why haven't you got, you know, universal suffrage, multi-party system? Whereas in China, the main emphasis is on the effectiveness of government. Is it able to deliver? And this is reflected in the whole way that the two political systems are organized. The whole way in which politics is organized is around getting elected. For example, leads to a very short-term mentality, you know, because you've always got to get votes. And this, I think, is a big problem in the West because it conspires against long-term thinking. And I think that the Chinese system is very, very different. I mean, the Chinese system, you know, thinks in very long term. You know, it thinks in, you know, between congresses, always thinking 10 years, 20 years, 30 years, you know, the target for 2049 and so on. This is a totally different way of thinking and much, much more, in my view, scientific. Because, you know, most things take a long time. The other problem is that the kind of people who become politicians, political leaders, you know, in the West, it's all about, you know, popularity, not your ability to deliver. So the Western politician, typically, their trade is in words. Whereas in China, it's totally different. You know, you're not going to become General Secretary of the Communist Party unless you've already performed at many levels of governance and in the party.
The main difference between the two political systems in the US and in China is that China is ruled by a vanguard, while the US is ruled by elites, that is, by private capitalist corporations which outsource the task of political government to professional executive agencies, which they call political parties. China is governed essentially by a national vanguard. And the difference between a vanguard and elites is that vanguards respond to the needs of the people, and elites, on the contrary, put forward first and almost their own particular interests. So China is not a one-party dictatorship because it advances the material well-being of the people. And in addition, it step by step advances the rule of law, the civilian rights of its citizens. And that is why the Chinese government has the overwhelming support of the great majority of citizens. And the support of the majorities for a government that gives the system the status of being democratic in a real sense, not in a formal sense. Because a democracy is defined as the rule of the majority.
The biggest misunderstanding of the CPC in the West comes from its failure to realize that the CPC has improved the standard of the living of the Chinese people in the last 40 years more than any Chinese government has in 4,000 years of Chinese history. 800 million people have been rescued from absolute poverty. You have a middle class of 300 to 400 million people. The rest of the world doesn't understand how much the CPC has done. And I think the mistake that the United States is making is that it doesn't understand that the Communist Party of China has changed and adapted in many significant ways. So for example, CPC is one of the most meritocratic political parties in the world. It selects among the best people to join the party. Now that's something that is actually absolutely unknown to many Americans.
The CPC is the ruling party in China, and it has earned this status during many trials and tribulations over the past 100 years. It has chosen the path of socialism, and after several experiments, it was improved to achieve fast development since launching reforms and opening up. It offered the nation new perspectives of rejuvenation by putting forward the long-term program of Chinese dream. It continues to prove its right to rule over the past few years, uniting and leading the nation under harsh conditions of the natural disaster called COVID and a man-made calamity called the New Cold War. The CPC's self-motivation comes from the deep feeling of patriotism. Patriotism is the essence of socialism with Chinese characteristics. This patriotic formula and practical results of the Chinese dream allow the CPC to rule 1.4 billion Chinese in the 21st century with all the information technologies and artificial intelligence.
This year, China celebrates the 100th anniversary of the establishment of the CPC. The Communist Party was established as a result of China being in great disarray, of ordinary people suffering terrible hardships, of China being ravaged by imperial powers. There were many ideas how China should go forward. Looking back is always easy. Looking forward, it's always very difficult. And China has got to look forward. To me, what is important in this 100th anniversary is to look back and learn, to find a path which where none exists today. You can learn from other countries, but China's path will be a unique path to the future.